A check on the weather now. Storm signals may be raised in some areas in northern Luzon tonight or by Thursday morning due to Tropical Depression Obet. It was last spotted 1,025 kilometers east of extreme northern Luzon, with sustained winds of 45 kilometers per hour and gusts of up to 55 kilometers per hour. State Weather Bureau Pagasa says Obet may intensify into a tropical storm prior to crossing the Babuyan Islands or the extreme northern part of mainland Luzon between Friday evening and Saturday morning. It is expected to exit the Philippines by Sunday. In other parts of the country, severe localized thunderstorms are expected this afternoon. A commuters group objects to the proposed surge pricing for public transportation. See, some transport groups are asking regulators for a fare surcharge during rush hour. They insist the recently approved fare hikes have not helped much since oil prices continue to rise. The group, Commuters of the Philippines, says a better option would be to give more government subsidy to jeepney and bus drivers.
Backmuller tinatawag yan, yung jeep sa bus, backmuller yung transport yan. No, so hindi mo pwedeng gawa ng surge pricing yan, unang-una, dahil ano yan eh, panglakatan yan. No?
Mm-hmm.
Kasi kumbaga po, pag nawalan naman ng TLVS, nawalan, hindi ka magdadrive ng kotse, mm-hmm. o hindi ka masakay ng taxi, mm-hmm. Yan ang kumbaga fallback mo. Kasama ang loob ng mga commuter na parang, kayo lang ba nahihirapan sa panahon na to? Lahat naman tayo nahihirapan.
Jeepney operators are seeking a 1 peso additional charge, while bus operators want an extra 2 pesos during morning and evening rush hours. The Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board is studying the petitions. The agriculture damage caused by Typhoon Neneng rises to 366 million pesos. That's up from the Disaster Management Agency's earlier estimate of 182 million pesos. The National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council says at least 19,000 hectares of agricultural land were affected by flooding in the Ilocos region, Cagayan Valley, and Cordillera Administrative Region. More than 14,500 farmers and fishermen were also affected. Meanwhile, damage to infrastructure was pegged at 81.5 million pesos. Over 100 families remain in evacuation centers several days after the storm hit. President Marcos graces the 121st anniversary of the Philippine Coast Guard with a vow to accelerate their modernization efforts. ABS-CBN's Katrina Domingo filed this report.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. assured the Philippine Coast Guard that his administration will be supporting modernization efforts for the agency in the next 6 years. Now, during the 121st anniversary celebration of the PCG, the president told the agency that their personnel will never sail as a lone body in these unsettling waters, especially because the PCG plays a key role in the government's law enforcement initiatives and serves in the front line in the defense of the Philippines' maritime territory, economic zones, and baselines. The president urged the PCG to continue its dedication and persistence and to move full throttle towards the realization of its vision to become a world-class guardian of the sea.
The entire force of the Filipino people will fuel your voyages, aiding you in your mission as you brave our seas and make a difference in the lives of the people that you serve. As your leader, I assure you that this administration will always be behind you, supportive of your efforts and initiatives to modernize the Philippine Coast Guard, which will redound to the better delivery of service to the nation. With the brave men and women of the Philippine Coast Guard guarding our shores, I'm confident that we will be able to steer our nation in a direction towards safer shores and ever onwards to a better, brighter, and more prosperous future.
But ironically, the PCG's 2023 budget was actually reduced by 300 million pesos. PCG Acting Commander Commodore Armand Balido tells us that the PCG originally pitched for a 21.26 billion peso budget, but the agency is now coordinating with the Department of Transportation to find ways to reinstate the slashed fund. Balido says a bulk of the 300 million pesos was supposed to be used to cover fuel expenses for the PCG's vessel. Coast Guard Commandant Admiral Artemio Abu noted that in May 2022 alone, the PCG deployed 5 ships and air assets to install sovereign markers or buoys on 4 areas in the Kalayaan Island Group. It has also deployed the BRP Teresa Magbanwat to support the resupply mission for the Philippine troops on Ayungin Shoal. The PCG chief says the Coast Guard also needs to fund the services of more personnel as the agency expects to have a total of 24,500 people by December.